Hey guys, Mike Facile here, and in this video we're talking about how to make money online dropshipping on Amazon and how beginners earning $100 to $700 a day with this new method. More of that after the intro. Hey guys, how's it going? Mike Facile here. Welcome to this video. Before we actually begin, I remind you that several spots have opened up for this week's free workshop where it's the fastest and easiest way to make money online. Sign up for it in the link below. We literally have a 62-year-old woman go from zero to 160 grand profit in 90 days. Check it out now. So one of the best ways to make money online right now this year is by dropshipping. The reason why is because with dropshipping, you don't need actually your own inventory. You don't need your own products. You don't even have to buy thousands of products from China like what I used to do when I was trying to sell from Amazon. And it's a lot easier with a far less risk to start making money online and just getting your foot into the water. Now, this was important for me because growing up, I didn't have much. You know, my parents came to America from the Philippines, and growing up, I never had money to start my own business. So when I first got started, I wanted to find one of the easiest ways to make money without having to be spending thousands of dollars for products that I didn't know if I was gonna sell. This is where dropshipping came from. And with dropshipping, the reason why I was able to grow so much from zero to $1.5 million in sales in my first year was because of this concept of leverage where I never had to buy the product until after I sold it. And that is the beauty of dropshipping. When most people ask me like, well, Mike, how can I go and get started? What are the easiest ways for me to get started? Where can I go ahead and get started? This is what I wish I would tell them. You know, one of the best ways to get started with dropshipping is actually Amazon, because there's literally so much people that are on their eyeballs looking at Amazon, buying things every single day, buying the weirdest things, right? But in this way of dropshipping, I want to tell you the first way, which is the easiest way to get started, and it is by dropshipping clothing. Now, the thing about Amazon, what most people don't know, is there's this thing called Merch by Amazon, where essentially all you got to do is upload your design work onto their t-shirts, you list the price, and if someone goes ahead and buys it, they're the ones that do the shipping, the handling, the customer service, and you're just earning royalties from that. Back in the day when I was doing this print-on-demand style thing, you know, we were selling elephant t-shirts and cat t-shirts and dog t-shirts and Jesus t-shirts, and we were able to get upwards to actually $1,000 a day in revenue with this, with about like 20 to 30% profit margin, so $200 to $300 a day in profit. But the beauty about this is it was very passive because I didn't have to deal with actually buying the products myself as well as doing the shipping and handling myself, which could take a lot of headache if you don't know exactly how to do that. So with Merch by Amazon, it works pretty simple. Like someone comes up to here, for example, types in cat t-shirt, right? And just like that, all these things, these are what people are searching for. So if I come in here and type in cat t-shirts for woman funny, all these things people are buying for $17, $21, $19. And how this essentially works is if I click on this right here for $19, I'm gonna click on this and someone's gonna go and buy this, right? With that $19, Amazon essentially drop ships it from their inventory and ships it to them, and they'll pay you a royalty. In most cases, it'll be like $4 or $5 or something for sale. But the beauty about this is you're not running any advertising, you're not spending money on ads, because people are going to Amazon to go ahead and buy this already as it is. Now with this method of dropshipping, your biggest focus is really just focusing on the designs. How can you find really high quality designs? So what I like doing in the past, for example, is going to Pinterest and typing in competitors' t-shirts. I would type in all pins and then cat t-shirts. And what I would do in this research phase is I would just screenshot all of these things as possible, right? When I'm screenshotting all of these things that I see would work, these are concepts that would really work well with print on demand and dropshipping on Amazon with this merch. I would do the exact same thing with Redbubble. I would type in cat t-shirts, and then I would sort everything by orders in best selling. Again, all of these things are popping up, so of course I would just screenshot them because they're the best selling, right? Same thing in AliExpress. I would type in on here for customer research, cat shirt. I would sort everything by orders. Now I know these are all the concepts that are doing the best. The next thing that I would do is literally go to Upwork and type in graphic designer. One thing's for certain, I'm not a graphic designer, so why on earth would I spend time learning this thing when I could literally hire somebody for really cheap to go ahead and do it? Back in the day, what I would do is I would go over here and type in Philippines and sort for less than $10 an hour, right? And with all the screenshots that I made of all of these things that were working well, I saw these as concepts that I could model in other niches. So for example, I saw this as cat mom or crazy dog lady. You could do this in crazy cat lady or crazy beagle lady or crazy, you know, elephant lady, right? All these things that people associate with. And then what I would do is I would screenshot all these things and hire somebody from the Philippines for literally less than $10 an hour, and they would do all these designs for me. And the beauty about this is some of these designs take like seconds to make. Like this design right here, This would probably take like, I don't know, 3 minutes to make. This one would probably take another 5 minutes to make. This one would take like 2 minutes to make. This one would take like 2 minutes to make. You could literally get a bunch of designs that would work really, really well for that. You could then literally come on here, upload the designs, and then list it on here. And the way that you really make money with this dropshipping method on Amazon is you do this for literally every single type of niche imaginable, right? If I just type in Beagle t-shirt, for example, you see all of these things that people are selling. And the coolest thing about this is it's no cost to you, which is what makes it really popular for beginners who are just getting started dropshipping on Amazon. The second way to make money online with dropshipping on Amazon is using Amazon as a supplier. And then we would, for example, sell things on eBay. So back in the day, what I would do is I would actually sell like things like ab wheel rollers on eBay, right? And the coolest thing about this is you could see just the slew of prices that people are buying things for. As long as you make it really cool, you could charge very, very high. So you can see this is $29 and it's sold for 200, there's 211 sales, so you know that's proven to sell. Back in the day, what I used Amazon was for a supplier in dropshipping. And I would type in the exact same thing, ab wheel roller. When I did that, you find similar ones that you see, like for example, right here for only $12, right? Check this out. You know, you see like this nice little picture right here. This one goes for $29. And my cost, if I buy it here, is only $12. How insane is that, right? So what I would essentially do back in the day is I would use, like I said, Amazon as a supplier, and I would just literally list as much things as I could for free on eBay as possible. Because if I made a sale, for example, someone bought 210 out of these, right? One person bought, I would literally take the $39, or in this case, it was $29 in US, and then eBay gives you the customer's information. I would literally go ahead and add to cart and buy this for $12, and then I would go ahead and ship it to them directly. Just like that, you see the profit difference from $29 right here. I don't know why it says in Australian, $29 right here, and then $12 right there, just like that. And right now I'm in Bali, Indonesia. That's why it's $31 shipping and handling. You won't have that if you're doing it in the US, right? The fact that I'm in Indonesia right now, because that's where I live, that's the only reason why it's there. For you, it would just be prime shipping and it would be free 2-day shipping, right? And you can see all these other things as well that you could go ahead and sell. And then what would happen, you literally buy this with the customer's money and then you ship it to them directly. This is literally how I made my first $100 a day online, because of the fact that I was like, oh my God, it doesn't cost me any money. All it takes is literally me saving these images on here and creating, you know, listings here onto eBay. And this is exactly how I do it. The two most important things are literally titles and images. What I mean by that is, notice here, notice all of these things right here. These are what people are searching for. So what I would do back in the day is when I would, you know, upload things from Amazon onto eBay, I would make sure that all of my titles would have something similar to this, because this is what people are searching for. So I would remember, like, I would type in for the title ab wheel roller, gym, fitness, equipment, yoga, home, workout. I know that sounds like a ridiculous title, but these are literally what, oh wait, one more, abdominal, because I see the word abdominal. These are what people are actually searching for on eBay. And the more keywords that I literally put in the title, the more likely people are gonna go ahead and find me from different things. So even if I might not rank for ab wheel, I might rank for like fitness equipment. And if people type in fitness equipment, you know, they're gonna see all of these other things that might not necessarily have your product on there. Like, look at this, this is $25. You could find these exact things for like $10 or $12 on Amazon. Then when someone goes ahead and, for example, buys this ab wheel roller for like $28, I still don't understand why it says Australia when I'm not in Australia right now. I'll literally just take the money from there and then, you know, buy it from Amazon. Now, when it comes to images, the most important thing in images is what you save it as. So when you save it as it, there's like this ridiculous title right here. You never want to save it like that. What makes you found easier on eBay is when you literally use the title ab wheel roller, home workout. Whatever people are searching for on YouTube or on eBay, you wanna make sure you save the image as that, because it's what's known as metadata. I know it sounds like pretty complicated and whatnot, but all you really need to know is this image now has that word glued to that image. Meaning, the fact that eBay starts seeing that, because that's what eBay reads, right? eBay is like this computer algorithm thing. They associate more with when someone types in ab wheel roller, they will associate your product more than, you know, the rest. And that will allow you to start ranking higher and higher in the search engines and allow you to get more and more sales. And that's how you can make really good money with dropshipping on Amazon. A good way that you can increase on that is if you go and get like a free cashback site, like for example, topcashback.com. With Top Cash Back, you can literally get upwards to 8% cash back for every purchase that you shop from Amazon. Now think about how insane that is, right? If I'm getting $100, if I'm spending $100 on Amazon every single day to dropship things on eBay, that's essentially $8 for free every single day that I'm making. But remember, I wasn't spending $100 a day on Amazon when I was younger to do this. I was spending $1,000 a day of my customers' money. Think about this. I was selling $2,000 worth of product every single day on eBay. And from the $2,000, I was buying things from Amazon for like about $1,000 to $1,500 worth, right? My profit margins were like very small with this method because I was only using Amazon. There's a lot better suppliers. You can check out my YouTube channel with all the suppliers that we do for dropshipping. But when I was spending like $1,000 a day on Amazon, that was essentially $80 a day for free. So just like that, it was able to get $80 a day for free on that. And to make even more money with this method, if you buy the products from Amazon, through Top Cashback, through the Amazon Cashback site, but you use Travel Rewards credit cards, like for example, let me just refresh that, like Amex Gold, as well as like Chase Sapphire Preferred. If you spend $4,000 in the first 3 months, you get 80,000 free bonus points that you could use for either Travel Rewards points to get hotel stays, or for me, it was like free business class tickets, or you could get that in equivalent in terms of cash. So think about it, a lot of it's like 2% cash back as well. So that's like almost, if you combine this with this, you're essentially getting paid 10% cash back for every single $100 that you spend of your customer's money. So that's one of the most passive income streams ever, because you're not dealing with all of like the hardships of like, you know, dealing with the shipping and handling, because you're making all of your money with the cash back and the Travel Rewards credit card points. I remember the reason why I was spending $1,000 a day, $1,500 a day, on Amazon while profiting very little on eBay was because most of my money was coming from my cashback sites as well as from my Travel Rewards credit card points that I reimbursed into cash instead of just, you know, getting the travel rewards sometimes. And as you can see, same thing as well, 60,000 membership rewards points for the first 4,000 spent. Most people don't have $4,000 to spend in the first 3 months, but if you're using your customers' money that you're making on eBay and you're buying it and dropshipping it from Amazon, you like it's easy to spend $4,000 because it is not your own money, guys. This is the newest way to make money online. Hopefully you can take advantage of this. For me, I pivoted into easier ways to make money online, as you can see in the past 30 days with this new method that we talked about in this free workshop below. We pulled in 35 grand, and in the past 7 days, we pulled in about like $8,000 net. The beauty about this is it's not my own product, and I don't have to have a huge team. I can just do this by myself. Someone else does the product management, the fulfillment, the customer service, the shipping and handling, dealing with customers' complaints, the returns. Someone else does that, which is why I like this new method better. And with this new method, a 62-year-old woman went from zero to 160 grand profit in 90 days. So check it out in the free workshop below. It's completely beginner friendly. And if you're just new to this channel, check out my podcast of all these multimillionaires that make a bunch of money online. I mean, this 11-year-old girl turned down $30 million. This guy makes $1 million per month profit. All of these literally live here in Bali, where I am living right now with my cute little fatty puppy. But that being said, check it all out in the links below. With that being said, I love you guys. See you guys later.